Hello everybody. So today we're looking at how to use Python with YAML for network automation, and we're going to be looking at how you can use conditional logic in Jinja to create your configs. So what we're going to do first is just have a quick look at what Jinja is and what YAML is. So Jinja, if you've not seen the first two videos in this series, then have a look at those. Jinja is a way to use a template and placeholders to create multiple documents. So let's have a look at what YAML is. YAML, let's just bring up, what is YAML? Definition. YAML is a human-readable data serialization standard that can be used in conjunction with all programming languages and is often used to write configuration files. So it's a little bit like JSON. If we just scroll down, you'll see the format here, and it's comparable to JSON where you have key value pairs. YAML is a bit more human readable. There you see this JSON version, and that's the YAML version. I think probably the best way to demonstrate this is actually by doing a bit of code with it. So what I've actually based this tutorial on is an excellent article by networkbit.ch, Python Jinja2 template YAML file Cisco example. I'll put the link to this in the description. So I've based it upon this, although I don't know when this was written. There's just a couple of tweaks I've done to it. So I'll just show you what I've had to tweak, and then we'll come back and look at the rest. So I've had to tweak YAML load. It's now YAML full load. You get a deprecation error. So let's look at the actual tutorial. Create a YAML file, which is what we'll look at in a minute. You create a YAML file, you create a Python script, and then you run the Python script, and you hopefully get some code that you can then copy and paste, or you can script for an update onto your router, switch, firewall. Doesn't have to be Cisco. I'll typically mention Cisco because obviously that's the most common flavor of network device, but it certainly doesn't have to be. And if you're not familiar with BGP, BGP is a routing protocol, so we don't really need to go into that, but it just features in the config. So as mentioned, we create a YAML file. We've also got our Python file, and then we will have our output, which is what we will go off and use on our switch, router, whatever. Right. If you've seen previous video, you will have seen where I've used placeholders. So host name, double curly braces, space either side of your variable, and then that's your variable name. The difference here, let me just make this bigger. That's better, isn't it? The difference here is that we've got some conditional logic. And if you saw one of my early videos where I was making multiple CSVs and multiple Word documents, multiple Word documents based on values read from a CSV. I'll put the link up here somewhere. What you do is you have a block, and then you just say, for instance, we've got a for loop there, and we've got a for loop there. We just end. So whatever you start with single curly braces, you have to end. So if that was an if, you'd have to put if down here with the percentage signs. Use percentage signs where it's conditional. What we're doing here is we've got an interface loopback one, and then depending on what ID we pass it, will determine what the actual IP address of that loopback is. So if we had multiple devices, then based on the ID, we would obviously give each device a unique IP address, which is what we want. We don't want two devices with the same address. What we're doing here, so this is for VLAN name in VLANs.item. So this is a Python dictionary. We're just saying we want the VLAN to be the key name, and then we want the name to be the value. So that's key, value, dictionary items. And then down here again, we want the router BGP. So the ID, we're using that ID twice. So if that ID is 66, that'll also be 66. And then we say for neighbor in BGP. So if we've got three neighbors, we will have three lines based on this again. So we will have neighbor. And when you want to access the YAML, you need to use the full stop to access the indented part. So if I just show you the YAML, 1, 2, 3, we've got three lots of indentations, and that's where we use the dot. So if I go back to here, you see we use the dot neighbor and dot remote AS. Good. So I think the best thing to do is now to go across to the code. And again, this is based on the network bit.ch. I don't know if that's I won't comment. Imports from Jinja. So as we did before with my first two videos, from Jinja 2, import environment, file system loader, import YAML, so that's new. And if you've not installed it, you can install it. There's some nice extensions for VS Code to work with YAML as well. So if this looks like a full page of writing and text, to be honest, it could actually be just, without the comments, it could actually be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. Config equals YAML full underscore load. So you see, this is the new bit that was previously load. So yeah, that's been deprecated. So what we're doing is we load the YAML file and we turn that into an object. We load the template file, which is this. So we've got data, template, Python. So we've got three files. So the Python file needs to know about the YAML and it needs to know about the template. So we've told it about the YAML here. We're telling it about the template here. And then we get the YAML template. So that's got the J2, so that's the Jinja bit. So Jinja, YAML, and all of this is Python. So three things involved here: YAML, Jinja, Python. The best way is actually just to have a go and start small. So yep, copy this code and then modify it, break it, whatever. At the end, we use render. So again, if you'd seen my how to dynamically create Word documents, you'll have seen Eric Lapuyad's docx.tpl, and again, render. So render is basically, it's getting the YAML and it's transplanting the YAML into the placeholders in the Jinja, and then it's creating some output. So without further ado, I think it's time, if you're ready, to run it. So let's just have a go at that. Bring that up, let's clear the screen, and Python, so you just run the Python script. The Python reads the YAML and it reads the Jinja, so let's go. And there we go, we've got some code. Now that might not look very exciting, but we can paste that. If we copy and paste that, we can now paste that straight into our router, our live router. And notice we've got three lines here. So that was because we had three lines in the YAML here. So if, let's say we want to do this for another network. Say we wanted the 10.2 network. So again, just change that, save it, run it again, and there we go. So we can copy paste that, paste it into the router, and we're up and running. If you want to read more, go to blog.stackpath.com/YAML and then visit this site, because this is kind of where you will see a nice description of what I've just shown you. And it's a really good site for all things kind of network. So just remember to change the full, where was it? It just changed the load to load to a full load. That is how to create Python YAML network code. So hopefully this has been interesting, and yeah, we'll be back soon with something a little bit more adventurous. This is just kind of a bit of a taster. So yeah, if you're not familiar with YAML, have a read up on it, start writing your own, copy this code, modify it. I'm not putting it on GitHub. If you want me to, I can, but really this is kind of it's a starting point. It's not really anything that you would want to copy and use in production as such. So next I will be using similar version to this, but I'll actually be doing something more purposeful, and we'll be doing some real code on a real Cisco switch. So until next time, thanks for watching, and subscribe, thumbs up, and yeah, red button and all that. Thank you.